Welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm a 53-year-old female from Rochester, Kent, which is in Medway, the Medway towns, and Rochester is where Charles Dickens used to live. Right, Alexa, what's the time, please?
The time is 6:52 a.m.
Alexa, what's the date today?
Today is Thursday the 24th of March.
Alexa, the weather.
In Rochester, it's 3 degrees Celsius with fog. Today, you can expect intermittent clouds with a high of 17 degrees and a low of 3 degrees.
Yeah. I'm just going to look outside and see if I can see any fog. I don't think I can. The sun's out. See, when I walk the dog later on, whether there's any mist or fog outside. Yesterday I had a bath and a shower. Well, what I did was I soaked in the bath, had a nice bubble bath, and then I had a shower as well to rinse my hair, wash my hair. So I stayed in most of yesterday. I took Max out 3 times around the field, last night included. I walked with the torch last night down the bottom end. I do a circuit is what I call it. I go right the way around, going around the field, and I come back. So I got to the field, past the fence in, and my phone rang. It was my mum, Jennifer. She was very short. The call was about 1:29. She said she hasn't heard from Charlotte. She can't get through to Charlotte's mobile phone. It crackles. There's nothing she can do about it. She thinks there's something wrong with the phone. She couldn't get onto the phone company. And she's not paranoid. Her Jennifer isn't paranoid. So she hasn't heard from Charlotte on the phone for almost a week. And the phone crackles when she rings it. But when my mum rings my mobile, she gets through to me. So maybe Charlotte's not well and she's turned her phone off. Maybe Charlotte... You know, I dropped my phone on the field, didn't I? I lost my phone. Things happen. I mean, Charlotte knows my mum's on her own. Charlotte knows my mum needs help. I'm sure when Charlotte's able to ring my mum up, she will. There's no problem. Today, I have got to go and have a blood test, a follow-up blood test. From the blood transfusion and the iron infusion. That's in Stroud. I haven't got a car, like I keep saying. I can't drive, so I've got to walk over the Stroud Bridge again. So later on, I've got to go out and have a blood test just to see how my iron levels are doing, and blood tests can pick other things up as well. I was reading about this case on my phone yesterday. I get notifications of things, how this woman was diagnosed with stage 2 colon cancer because she'd had this pain for some time, and they put it down to irritable bowel syndrome, the usual stuff, and she kept persisting. They said it was other things, and then, you know, she said it felt like her poo was coming into her mouth. Her mouth tasted like poo. So she kept on and on, and about 6 or 7 months after continuously trying, having scans, etc., turns out stage 2 colon cancer. So I was reading about that yesterday. On the field, there was the guy with the pug dogs again, but he wasn't right behind me. I was way up on the field by the time he came out. With my dating site, I'm just getting the odd message now, good morning, and did you sleep well? And when I had a message yesterday, maybe we can meet one day, and then you go outside and you see people meeting each other, and I meet nobody, so I just take no notice of that. My mum can't see me because it's something to do with Charlotte. I don't know why, but there you are. And I'm on my own all day. Like I said, I've got to go and have a blood test today. Last night I watched the Council House Swap on Channel 5. Council House Swap, where council tenants, this was in Leicester and London, we're going around to view each other's council homes with a view to swap. There was a very thin lady with a bun in her hair with her husband and a boy viewing homes, and they were fussy. They wanted something they couldn't find. So that's what people do when they can't afford to move. They swap, they try and swap. So eventually I'll try and do that, but you know, you've got to give the place a great big clean, make sure it's spick and span, everything. Alexa, can you put LBC Radio on?
LBC London from Global Player.
You'll be able to download the app, Global Player app, and then you'll be able to download as many of your favourite LBC shows and a range of brilliant podcasts as well. Have yourself a nice day. As I say, enjoy the weather. It's not going to be the most brilliant in a few days' time. So if we make the most of it now, you should be able to get your sort of your little tanning in. And way back from Tenerife, says Pat, and we have one of your famous bacon rolls. If I don't get one today, I'm going to be in such a bad mood by tomorrow. But it doesn't matter because I'm still enjoying the weather as it happens. I'll be back with you tomorrow morning at 4 a.m. for Steve Allen's early breakfast. 10 o'clock this morning. It's James O'Brien, but right now, with your Thursday breakfast, it's Nick Ferrari.
Thanks, Steve. At 7 o'clock on Thursday, March the 24th, in an exclusive interview with Boris Johnson here on LBC, as the Prime Minister boards his jet to go to Brussels, he's going for gold, determined to seize Putin's gold reserves.
So we need to do more economically. Can we do more to stop him using his gold reserves, for instance, in addition to his cash reserves?
The Prime Minister praises the lion-like courage of President Zelensky.
President Zelensky has proved to be a quite remarkable leader of his people. He's rallied them.
Bid to try and host the Euro 2028. Stay tuned for that full interview. And, of course, all the analysis you need. Much tax gain, of course, from Rishi Sunak. But there's still plenty of pain for pensioners and others. It's all after the 7 o'clock news on LBC.